Hello boys and girls, it's Mike here, one good short play. Today we are playing The Adventures of Dino Riki on the NES. I've heard of this, I think. That sounds familiar as it comes out of my mouth. Puts and stuff. Okay. I once had a meeting with the son of the guy who ran hunting. It was just after I made my game power. Cool, it's a top-down shooter, and I like it. It feels very well balanced. Baddies are slow, bullets are a bit fast. Whoa, I say baddies are slow. Check this out! That was still good, still good. Oh, I get a them. Can I get a them? I can get a them. Oh, I could have got the fifth one all. But never mind. We live and learn. Let's move on. Yeah, I can't remember his name now. Was it Rob Hudson? Nice blow. I made a game called Power Up, a space shooter, a while ago when indie developers were in. Oh, it got a bit hard. The arc went, whoa! it went down pretty well. And I got this meeting in Manchester with a guy called Rob. I didn't really know the relevance of Hudson because I was a specky owner who came to it quite late in the day. Whole life lost for that. Quite late in the day. And that sucked. So it was like the 128 era that I was a big part of, more than the 48k era. And I think that meant I missed a lot of the seminal Hudson games and Uridium and stuff like that, which is more of a C64 game anyway. I think. Flowers, give me the flowers. And it was just sped up. Okay, I'm getting the hang of it. And we talk about a game that he wanted to make, which is basically Uridium remade for the modern era. And he'd like my spaceships I made in Power. I will do a video on Power Up when I get to it on my game what I have made channel feed thing, you know, playlist. That's the one. Oh, this is harsh now. Yeah, he liked the way it made them, and he was thinking about graphic styles, and he wanted to know if I'd get involved, I think, with the art side of this game. So I did some overly detailed spaceships, trying really hard to get the gig. And he said they're very nice, and he'll be in touch. And they clearly weren't what he wanted at all, and he didn't get in touch, which kind of sucked. Cut to... A few weeks ago, I went to the Leeds Retro Game Affair with my art, didn't make any money. But Hudson was there with their new Uridium style game, Hyper Sentinel, which looks amazing. I mean, if you're into that sort of thing, which I'm not really. Uridium was always just too hard for me as a kid. But it looks like they made it a bit easier, and a bit more playable, and a bit more fun. I think maybe it was aimed at an older market than I was when I was a kid. And now that I'm possibly in that older market, I'd probably be interested more in it. But Uridium was clearly a good game. It clearly was a popular game. And I'd love to have been involved in the remake of it. But the graphic style, he went for this kind of ships made of Minecraft blocks kind of look. Pixels, voxels, I guess. Really super game, gorgeous. Whoever did it has done a great job. I was gutted not to be involved with it. I think if he'd said I want to do it in like voxels, if he'd known at that point, which I don't think he did. He didn't know at that point how he wanted it to look. But if he'd known, I'd have gone for voxels and, you know, boxes, 3D boxes essentially, and I'd have kicked its ass. But it wasn't to be, it just wasn't to be, quite simply. Bit gutted, love to work on that, but hey, what can you do? It was, you know, it was great to meet someone who was related to someone so important to the games industry. As they Rob's dad was basically Hudson Soft, was it Soft? Hudson Soft. The company that made this and many other much more seminal games. This is actually quite good. It's a top-down shooter, clearly, but it kind of masquerades well as a character-based, I don't know, well, it's got, the character-based elements really hides its top-down shootiness, because we're not flying around the spaceships. Ooh, ow. That was a kind of double-edged sword, wasn't it? Pick up the health, take a hit. It's really tricky. I mean, again, it's just a bit too difficult. Bit of bullet hell, wild baddies are coming at you really fast, while dodging floor obstacles. That's full on. You know, the sections of the skin are just full on, and they're just out to hurt you. Although, I think the key to getting on in this game is to really go for the powers. I'm not, as you can see, very good at shooters. I'm not terrible at them. It's just, to get by in the shooter world, you've got to be really good at shooters. I think my shooter was, I was hoping to kind of make mine the medicine for that, and make it more accessible to everyone. I really slowed down the bullets in that game. I mean, there are, don't get me wrong, there are moments when it gets really nasty. But, especially on the last level, but again, I balance it so that, oh, come on, so that it's safe for the last level. I think I took a hit, and it took me out of the air, of me, you know, of me jump. That's just silly. Early on in the level, it's a really nice game. It's until those little dudes come that are swinging left and right, because they're moving too fast to actually get a hit or not. It's impossible to avoid certain things. It's impossible to kill... Hey? Ooh, why did he jump suddenly not working? It's impossible to kill certain things. Rage quit. I liked that game at first, and the more I played it, the more I loathed it. Not that I loathe it, it's just that it's too blooming hard. 1989? That's quite late. It's not a bad game, it's just... The difficulty detracts from the fun for me. And that's a bit of a shame. Dino Riki, or the Adventures of Dino Riki on the NES. Thanks for watching.